Hey guys, it's Nicole, and this is going to be a video on dealing with negative feedback and criticism that's often personal in your nursing journey. I look at all of you guys' Instagrams, notes, comments, and I love the feedback. I love our communication and social network, and I really, really appreciate you guys taking the time to put comments and send me emails. Sadly, when I check your Instagrams and I read your comments, a lot of them deal with you receiving negative feedback on a personal level from your preceptor, and you kind of want my advice. And please believe that every nurse has been there where you're working really hard and the feedback you're getting is not professional in nature, it's personal. For example, in my nursing program, someone told me that I did not have the mental capacity to be a nurse. Now, that's cold-blooded right there. That cut deep, and it messed me up for a couple of weeks. And I'm not going to say I'm above feeling bad about something like that. I felt really terrible. But my husband was a person that told me, that really sounds personal. I wouldn't take it to heart. I wouldn't absorb it and try to contemplate it. Take it for what it is and move on as kind of a personal attack and go from there. And with that advice, that really helped me get through my nursing program, especially with dealing with preceptors who made things personal. Just because someone's a nurse, just because they have a master's degree or a bachelor's degree, does not mean that they're capable of giving constructive professional feedback and it not be personal. Some women just don't like other women. Some men just don't like, you know, a particular type of woman or man. There are people out there that you are not going to be able to please. I had a preceptor that had a preconceived notion about black people. When my husband brought me food one day, she asked me if that was my husband. Yes, my husband's white. There was clearly a problem with that. You know, you move on and you progress through your career, but this video is to say, do not let someone's personal opinion of who you are or the potential that they see stop you from doing what you want to do. I've had faculty members call me stupid, told me that, you know, I got a B minus in this class. I'm probably not going to be a good nurse. Even in my critical care class, I got a C, and I was told that I don't really think ICUs for you. It seems a little above, you know, what you're displaying in class. And if I would have let these negative comments stop me, I would not have applied an ICU. I would not be at an ICU now. I would not have taken the NCLEX. I get it. When you're a preceptor or an instructor, you see what you see and you want to give, you know, feedback to motivate that person. And I've been there. But if it's personal in nature, all it's doing is harming that person's self-esteem and potentially stopping them from being who they are or who they could be. So for everyone out there who is dealing with a preceptor or an instructor who makes you feel like crap because most of what they're saying is personal, you are not alone. I'm right there with you, but you cannot let this one person's perception of who you are or who they see currently stop you. Was I an idiot as a nursing student? Of course I was. Everyone's an idiot. You know, we all don't know everything out the gate. But fast forward to now, I think I'm a pretty proficient nurse. And if I would have let that person's opinion of me stop me from where I wanted to be, I would still be working at Red Lobster. So I, with that, I really say, you know, if it's professional feedback, like you need better time management, that's one thing. But if someone's telling you that your mental capacity or you're stupid or you're dumb and they're saying very, very personal things to you, smile, take it. Modify your behavior if it's appropriate or it needs to be done professionally, and leave it as that because it seems more personal than professional and you aren't going to get a good engagement out of this relationship. I've been precepted by many people who I could not stand and they didn't like me or my lifestyle or the color of my skin, and it was what it was. We worked together, I passed, I never saw them again, and I never talked to them again. So you are able to be a professional and have a utter disdain for someone. Trust me, I've been there. So again, do not give up. You've worked too hard to get where you are. We love you. If you guys have any questions or comments for me, as always, put those bad boys below. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next week. Bye. sure what the shadow is over here. I don't really know what that's about. I'm losing a whole bunch of weight, so my body's trying to keep up hormone-wise, and I'm just... adult acne, just... I just can't. My skin was doing so well when I was, like, super morbidly obese. I had a situation, a regimen, it was perfection. And now I've lost weight, and it's just, like, acne, cystic acne, and it's just, like, I'm too old for this. Mid-30s acne, they just don't mesh very well. So that's what I'm currently dealing with right now. I have a discount code for any of you people out there looking for a nursing chart. The coupon code is New Year, all one word, and you get 25% off. So check that out if you want to, it's up there. And life is well. It's good. I miss you guys. I'm trying to get back on doing videos every week. I hope you like them. I miss you guys. I love you guys. And school is starting again. So, you know, stressful times ahead. But you got me. I got you right.